Over the weekend, social media was awash with disturbing images of police officers using excessive force on Buvuma Woman Member of Parliament Susan Nakaziba Mugabi as they blocked her belated Women's Day celebrations. The legislator and some of her supporters have since been admitted in different hospitals where they are nursing severe wounds inflicted on them by the police officers. According to the police spokesperson Fred Enanga, 11 of the police officers have already been summoned at the Uganda Police Professional Standards Unit, where disciplinary action will be taken against them. These include the acting regional police commander, Assistant Superintendent Jamal Kanyesije, among other commanders.
The Inspector General of Police came out and instructed the Professional Standards Unit to open an investigation into the alleged beating and torture, first of all, of the Honorable Woman MP Buvuma, that is Honorable Nakaziba Susan, and some of her supporters. As a result, we've summoned the 11 officers who have first of all been removed from their duties and asked to report to the Professional Standards Unit headquarters for further investigations.
Enanga insists that MP Nakaziba's Women's Day gathering had not been cleared by the police and the Ministry of Gender, giving reason for police to block the event.
The second incident of unlawful assembly was registered in Buvuma after the organizers defied the guidelines also from the District Security Committee, which had resolved that the Women's Day celebrations that were slated for the 19th of April be postponed because there were disagreements between two parallel teams. One team involving the chairperson Buvuma Women Council, that is Nachobe Betty, and then the other team was the woman MP Buvuma District, that is Honorable Nakaziba Susan.
Meanwhile, police in Kasese have in custody three suspected ADF rebels who were arrested in a joint security operation conducted in the district. According to the police, the three suspects were in possession of three guns and numerous rounds of ammunition and are believed to have sneaked into the country from the neighboring DR Congo.
We registered four cases of murder by shooting and four cases of murder in general, four cases of murder by mob justice, three cases of aggravated robbery, there was one incident of rape, one case of death by electrocution.
Also, the police confirmed the true paternity of at least 16 out of the 19 children found in the custody of Amos Wetungura, a former pastor. Police confirmed that the DNA samples of the 16 children matched that of Wetungura, indicating that he is the true father of these minors between 1 and 7 years. Wetungura was arrested after police intercepted the children. By the time of their recovery, some of the children were in bad shape and some reportedly bore scars that might have been as a result of being tortured.
Three children are still admitted in hospital at Mulago, so we can't pick their tests according to the advice of the doctor. But we picked samples from 16 children whose results are out. So we want to confirm that the 16 out of 19 children aged 1 to 6 who were recovered from Onkowe have been proven to be the children of Amos Wetungura.
From the Traffic Directorate, at least 148 people died in road crashes between the 11th and 22nd of April. These crashes were mainly attributed to reckless driving.
465 were serious and 230 were minor. Out of the 832 crashes registered during that period, we have a total of 819 victims. Out of these, 148 people died, and 671 sustained serious injuries.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.